Hello and welcome to Nirmal Bank, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Hiral Daria. We have with us Kunal Shah, Head of Commodities Research, joining in. Kunal, welcome to the show. It's the last day of the year. So wishing you and the viewers a happy new year as well in advance. My first question coming to you is with regard to the dollar index. Entering into 2022, it's seeing some mild gains towards 96. What's the overall view that you have on the dollar index for 2022?
Yeah, so like you said, for wishing everyone very happy new year and wish that next year will be less volatile. I don't know, it's not going to be, but just a wish that the next year is going to be less volatile than what it was 2021. So for regarding the dollar index view, US cases are making all time high. So the US cases are almost 3 lakh cases per day and of COVID, and same way, you know, the cases in India are surging again. But like I said before, the infections are there, but the fatalities are very less, and that's the good part. And I think we should live with this. So dollar index is right now under pressure because of what is happening with the US numbers, and I think can remain under pressure. But interesting thing, what is happening in commodity market is what China is doing. So China today morning came up and bailed out one of the major realty developer over there. And it seems that China is very aggressive about the slowdown, and they are trying to get the construction demand back on stream. So yes, today all the property stocks, including Evergrande, which was going to fail, had rallied by 8% today. And that's the reason today all the metals are moving up and the sentiments have improved from China. So I think we are going to see some bit of follow-up buying for the day. Going to continue. So we have initiated buy calls from morning, and I think it should continue going forward during the day. So copper, zinc, nickel, all are, you know, going to go up during intraday session. Buy at dips is the strategy which one should follow. And already nickel target achieved. But long-term, we are having our own doubt. For the day, it seems it is going to be bullish.
Right. And overall, what's the view that you have on gold and silver for 2022?
Itna uncertainty hai, so much uncertainty. Gold and silver are looking bullish to me only. Yeah, I will not give. But right now, what is happening is there are talks that in budget, there will be duty cut in India. So by 2-3%. And that is the proposal which was given a few days back also. So if that takes place, you see COMEX gold is already $1,816. So it made a low of $1,790. From there, it moved up by $25. So almost on India, this should have translated into a move of 500 rupees, but the prices are not up even by 250 rupees. Yeah. So here it is factoring the slowdown scenario. Webinar challenge karu, huh? Yeah. So I think we are going to see buying going forward in 2022. Gold looks very, 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 very positive and very bullish in 2022. So even during evening session, we can see some pullback, but I'm not expecting beyond that.
Right. And with regards to crude, what's the sense that you have?
I continue with my bearish stance, but not for intraday. US stocks yesterday on Wednesday was making new low, but I'm not bullish on oil. So oil, I'm recommending to go short 5700 sell, 5740, 45 stop loss, and target should be 5620.
Right. So that's with regards to crude as well. Kunal, any other highlights that you have that one should be watching out for?
No, I think let us take a what happens on weekend is something we don't know what is going to happen with the COVID cases and all. So let's take it day by day rather than having a big positional view right now.
Right. And Kunal, anything on natural gas? There's a question coming in on that.
Yeah, so natural gas is very volatile. Weather is driving, but Mr. Biden has said that he expects gas prices to go down. So there is a tremendous amount of political pressure on all the global leaders to bring down the gas and energy prices. And that's the reason for me to remain. When the government itself wants that, they are going to attain it in any way, anyhow. So in India, what we saw, food inflation, government banned commodities. Same way in US also, they don't want this energy prices to go up. So they are going to definitely, you know, do something about it.
Okay.
So I'm expecting it to go down.
Right, you're expecting it to go down. I think these are the only questions coming up as well. Thank you, Kunal. Thank you, participants, for joining in. And Happy New Year once again.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.